adding network-attached storage devices in Stratocast. Before adding a network-attached storage device volume to Stratocast, there are a few things to plan and prepare. The client account you'll be adding the volume to should be added to Stratocast first. You'll also need to make sure the NAS device meets the minimum hardware requirements, which can be found in the System Requirements section of the online help guide. Also take a look at the supported device list from the Stratocast webpage, and make sure the units you wish to add can record on the NAS volume, and the NAS volume is supported within Stratocast. The NAS device used must be able to support multiple volumes per device, and not just multiple shared folders per volume. If you have any questions on the compatibility of your NAS device, please send an email to sales@stratocast.com. From the supported device list, we can see that units which support edge recording on an SD card will not always support NAS recording, and vice versa. Check the supported firmware for all hardware from the supported device list as well. It is important to take a few minutes before adding the NAS volumes to plan which video units will be recording to which volumes, and how much space each volume will need. Use the storage calculation formula included in the online help guide to figure out how much space each volume will need based on the camera's video quality settings and how many cameras will be recording to that volume. You will also need to consider how long you wish to keep recordings, which is called the retention period. Having this calculated ahead of time will ensure that your volumes do not run out of space before the retention period has passed, and you will always have room for your video files. We highly recommend having a dedicated NAS device for Stratocast, so the storage estimates on the camera page will be accurate, and you do not lose files in use by other systems. For best performance, it's recommended to occasionally format your NAS volumes, which can be done from the camera's edit page. Before adding the volume, make sure the NAS hardware has been configured and any disk management has been taken care of. The unit should be discoverable on the network before attempting to add volumes to Stratocast. NAS volumes must be created on the device, as well as shared folders, before we can add the volumes to Stratocast as well. For more information on setting up volumes and shared folders on Synology and Buffalo NAS devices, see the videos on these subjects from the YouTube channel or check the online help guide. Remember that each volume can only be a maximum of 2 terabytes, and you may only add 16 cameras per NAS device. The last step before adding your NAS volumes to Stratocast is to make sure the date and time is synchronized on all hardware you're using, both video units and NAS devices. If you're adding a new NAS volume to replace an existing one, please make sure both volumes will be on the same local network. Double-check the current NAS volume location from the device's edit page. To add a NAS volume to Stratocast, first click on the Clients button on the left side of the integrator interface to see a list of all existing clients. Click on the number in the Number of Devices column for the client you wish to add the NAS volume to. From the Devices page, click on the Enroll a Device button. You'll have the option of adding a video unit or a NAS volume. Make sure Add a Network Attached Storage Volume is selected and hit the Next button. From the NAS Volume Information page, enter the name of the device as you'd like it to appear in Stratocast. If you have the serial number for your NAS device, you can enter it here, although this field is optional and only used for your own reference. Select the manufacturer and model next. This field lists the units that have been tested and are fully supported. You may choose the other option if the unit you are using is not listed here, but you must first confirm with the Stratocast sales team that the device can be used. If the device is not on the supported devices list, send a message to sales@stratocast.com to find out if it's compatible, and please include the name and model of the NAS device. Stratocast needs to know the size of the volume that's being added as well. Please enter the same size as was used when creating the volume on the NAS device. Hit the Next button to go to the Network Information page. Enter the IP address or host name of the NAS device on the network. We recommend using static IP addresses, since DHCP or Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol addresses may change over time. enter the name of the shared folder next, as it has been set up on the NAS volume. Each shared folder must have a unique name, and there should only be one shared folder per volume on the NAS device. If you're adding this NAS volume to replace a current one, the names of both shared folders must be the same. Enter the credentials to be used for accessing this NAS volume, and hit the Enroll button on the bottom right. If you wish to cancel the creation process at any point, hit the X on the top right corner of the pop-up window. From the Devices page, the unit state will go to Creating, and finally to Enrolled when the unit has been added to Stratocast. You may now assign the NAS volume to a new or existing IP video camera.